Broadway is about to get beautiful as the new musical all about Carole King and her brill-building buddies starts performances at the Stephen Sondheim Theater. We're here at a special sneak peek to catch up with the cast. Oh my God, you're Carole King on Broadway starting tonight. Is that weird?
Yes. I don't have the hat, though. It's interesting to take it on every night because I think, especially in the part of the play that we're looking at, I think that period of time in her life was all about her learning how to accept the very thing you're talking about. So there's like comfort in that.
I actually don't know much about the real story. So what is so great about this story?
Well, I think it's just fascinating that that Carole King, who we all know from her album Tapestry, was writing with her husband and collaborator Jerry Goffin some of the biggest hits of the 60s that you never realized were hers. Some Kind of Wonderful, Up on the Roof, The Locomotion.
You know every song, you just didn't know that four Jews in a room in 1650 Broadway wrote all these tunes. It's mind-boggling, and I think those are the two secret weapons of the show, is a great story that you weren't expecting, and all of the music along the way before we get to Tapestry. So, you know, it makes for a really great show.
Women of a certain age freak out when they find out Carole King music is going to be on Broadway. I've encountered a bunch of them. What did you experience them in San Francisco? What was the reaction like?
They're dancing in the aisles. They're losing their minds and dancing in the aisles. Absolutely.
There's something about her music that sort of pierces your heart.
There's a great moment in the show when Carole starts to sing Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, and the whole audience just has this hush, this kind of collective sigh of everybody in the room remembering the first time that they heard that song, and there's just such great affection and love for this music.
Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel uninspired.
What is it like seeing Anika and Jarrod? Were you in the casting room? Were you able to sort of say, like, no, that she's all wrong for me. She's all wrong. That one's right.
We contractually had a part in picking the people who played us. So what you see is what we wanted you to get.
They are so perfect.
Yes.
And so funny. They add so much to the show. I couldn't be more delighted.
I think that the actors and Doug have made these characters so much like who they're portraying that it's hard for me to tell the difference. It's really, sometimes I'm watching Jessie on stage and going, wait, that's not my mom. Right, that's not my mom.
Obviously, we've seen a lot of musicals using sort of these pre-existing songs and pop songs and rock songs. What about this music and this story do you think really works?
I love that it's actually a play with music, really more than it is a musical. So it's a very smart book.
Doug McGrath, who wrote our book, you know, who wrote Bullets Over Broadway with Woody Allen and wrote for SNL. I mean, the level of humor in telling this sort of serious story, it makes it just really, really different and really hits you in a really real way.
He started by saying, we're not going to take these songs and try and shoehorn them in and make them have any narrative to them.
The quality of their music, I felt, would be more interesting when placed in the context of their lives. You know, their music has a deeper, richer, more sophisticated feeling than a lot of pop music of that period. I think one of the reasons people connect so much with Carole is because she wrote in such a personal way, and so did Jerry, who was her lyricist for a long, long time. They wrote about stuff people did not write about in pop songs.
She was part of that group that were just starting to sing songs like about themselves and about specific feelings and specific things they were going through, not just like, I love you, baby, you know, be my girlfriend, be my boyfriend, let's go to the sock hop. I think that's why people like really get behind it, because they feel like for the first time someone was like, especially women, they're like, oh my gosh, I know that feeling. You just gave voice to what I feel.
You made